One of the things that we get asked a lot is in regards to masking and gloving. First of all, the masking recommendations by the CDC are certainly reasonable. You know, masks aren't a be-all, end-all for safety when you're out in public, and masks have certain pros and cons that go with them. They are only effective to the extent that they are effective if you wear them appropriately. And when I say wear them appropriately, it's doing good hand hygiene before you put on the mask so that your hand masks are not contaminated even before they go on your face. When you wear the masks, they should fit over your nose, and generally there's a nasal bridge that you want to adjust, and you want it down underneath your chin, and you want it comfortable on your ears, or if you have to tie it behind your head. Some of the big errors that we see with masking are that folks wear that around their chin or touch their face and readjust their masks frequently. I've seen people wear the mask just over one ear and walk through the store and only put it on, for example, when they get to their car. I actually saw that happen just the other day. And I was like, wow, their car is probably the least risky place. I've seen people, you know, wear the mask, and then when they stop and talk to somebody else, they pull the mask down, which is exactly what you don't want to do when you're in close contact with folks. So this mask, once it's on, it should stay on, especially when you're within 6 feet of another person. And you also have to be careful that the mask doesn't make you feel invulnerable so that you do things that would put you at more risk. Go to more crowded places because you feel that this mask protects you, and or continue to touch the mask and touch objects without doing good hand hygiene and respiratory hygiene. Wearing gloves, whether you're in healthcare or whether you're using this in the community, is always a little bit of a double-edged sword. Gloves are best at protecting us from things that can either harm our skin under our hands and or cause significant contamination that then we could take elsewhere that are hard to remove, things that maybe are, you know, can stick to the skin or do other things. That's why gloves are helpful in healthcare. In the public, gloves are probably a little less helpful because you're not exposed to that type of materials. Gloves don't really protect you any more than hand hygiene does. And gloves also have that risk, just like masks do, of making you feel like because you're the gloves, it's protected. But know that the COVID virus, the COVID-19 virus, does not go through the skin. So it's not touching the object that actually has the risk to you. It's touching the object and then touching your face, your nose, your eyes, your mouth, and areas where the virus can get into your system. And can gloves be more harmful? The answer is yes. If it prevents you from doing the things that we know make a difference, which are hand washing for 20 seconds or more with soap and water, and or using alcohol-based hand gel. Both of those are highly effective, and the risk of gloves would be that you don't do that. And we don't recommend doing hand hygiene over gloves. We generally are not recommending gloves from the infection prevention side of the world when you're in public.